I'm the co-PI of the project in the building block number one, as part of the Holland Innovative Potato Initiative. In our project, we work together with a couple of other collaborators, so it's not only us. It's a close collaboration with the group of Harro Bouwmeester from the University of Amsterdam, who is responsible for a lot of the metabolic and more fundamental science behind the project and also behind the whole project ID. So that is for the academic part and the more scientific research part. But we also have a close collaboration with the people from the Wageningen research part, which is the bioscience department, who are very much involved in using genome sequences from potato, but also from the nematodes that we will talk about a little bit more in a minute. And also provide us with valuable data on, for example, transcriptome analysis and so on. So that's a very powerful support for the project as such. And on top of that, we also have a collaboration with the Wageningen research partners of plant breeding, because the research is on potato, and we also have some genetic components in the projects, and we get some support of them as well, among the support of the companies involved as users in this particular project. So you may wonder why we need so many people on this project, and the reason is actually because it's rather complex. We actually take the basis of the communication between potato and the cis nematode to develop novel strategies to control those nematodes. So that means that we need expertise on the nematodes, but we also need expertise on the genetics of potato, on how plants actually produce very complex components, which require very specific facilities, which they have in Amsterdam, for example. But also we need inputs from people with knowledge about bioinformatics to handle all the sequence information and so on. And in particular, we need also knowledge on the interaction between the cis nematode and the potato itself. Currently, we know that cis nematodes is a major problem in potato growing areas, and due to the ban on pesticide use, including soil fumigants, we are more and more depending on crop rotation and natural resistance in our current varieties. We also know that crop rotation is not very economic, and natural resistance is currently threatened by the emergence of novel virulent field populations. So actually we have to think about real different strategies to have an alternative method to control these major pesticides of potato. In this project, we take actually this very intimate interaction as a basis to think about novel strategies, which is focusing on the communication between the cis nematode and the potato. Because you have to realize that those worm-like structures which live in the soil live in a very dark area. They do not have eyes, but they need the host plant and the roots for their food. So if they don't find the host, they are actually lost, and they will starve. So they are depending on the potato to survive. Which means that they have developed very sophisticated strategies to be able to detect the host plant roots, in this case potato. And potato is able to release specific compounds, chemical compounds, in the soil, which the nematodes can detect. This is a very interesting process, basically, from, let's say, a scientific and more fundamental point of view to understand, but also for applications, because you can imagine if you can somehow interfere in that process, of course, you could block the nematode, basically, to invade the potato root and cause damage, and in the end, of course, yield loss. So that is the ultimate goal of the project, to use this fundamental knowledge, let's say, on the plant-nematode interaction and the chemical communication between the plant at the one point and the nematode at the other point, to interfere in that process.
I brought for you guys today an example of this powerful technique called virus-induced gene silencing and how we use it to tackle the chemical communication between potato plants and nematodes. And what we do is, with this technique, is we have to engineer plant viruses. In this case, we're using two plant viruses, tobacco rotavirus and potato virus X, which are very well known to the potato breeder. And by engineering these viruses, we introduced little pieces of other genes that belong either to the plant or to the nematode into the genome of the virus. Then we inoculate these viruses into the plants, and as I'm showing here in the example with the gene called PDS, we can trigger a very strong response from the plant that then will knock down these genes that we are targeting. And we assume that with this technique, we can also silence genes in the nematode. And this is where we're trying to break through with the technology. By doing this, we can perform later experiments in the lab where we look at changes in the levels of hatching of potato cyst nematodes. And we can also look, together with our colleagues in Amsterdam, at the chemical composition of root exudates that have had genes silenced using this method. So let's have a look at how this really works in practice in the laboratory experiments. We start with in vitro potato cuttings that have to be propagated until they generate roots. So we cut internodia, very tiny pieces of potato. We transfer them to a sterile medium where they can grow and develop roots. And once they have small amount of roots, we transfer them to these pots with a special kind of soil called silver sand, which is essentially made out of sand. In this kind of setting, we can perform experiments inoculating these viruses into the plants that will lead to the knockdown of the genes. But we can also perform nematode infection experiments. One interesting characteristic of this sort of experiment is that we start with in vitro plants, because potatoes grown from tubers actually are very strong and very healthy, and they tend to overcome the infection of these viruses that are genetically manipulated. So we have to have very special care at the design and operationalization of these experiments, so that we can get highly efficient knockdown of our genes of interest. So what I'm showing here is the example of this gene called PDS, which is a gene from the potato plant, and all other green plants also possess this gene, or a related form of it, that is associated to chlorophyll, of course, deposition. So once we interfere with the production of these genes, we get this sort of completely white or fairly white potato plants, almost albino, if you will. But in reality, we're going to be silencing genes that are involved in the chemical production of these compounds that are perceived by the nematode. And we will also put genes of the nematode, trying to knock down genes there. As you can imagine, these techniques we're applying here are very advanced. But they can have, with a little bit of time, have a practical application in the field. So what we're generating here are proof of concepts, where we're using screening methods to find and to show that these genes that we are interested in are really the ones involved in the release of certain chemicals from the potato roots that lead to the hatching of the nematodes, or, in the case of the nematodes, that these are the genes that are responsible for the nematode perception of the chemicals that are released by its hosts, in the case, the potato. So in terms of practical applications, we see this as a sort of a helping hand for breeders that can use these genes and track them with markers on their potato populations. So it's not really involving genetically modified organisms, but it's looking at natural variation within potato varieties. And we can also look at this from the point of view of the nematode, where we can come up with novel solutions such as chemicals, biological molecules that can either block, thus suppressing the hatching of these cyst nematodes, or that can stimulate the hatching of these nematodes in the absence of the potato plant As in, for example, when you're doing crop rotation and you have cereals planted in that moment, you could apply certain biological molecules or chemicals that will stimulate the hatching of these cyst nematodes. And because they are not going to find their hosts, they are going to die because they will not have nutrients to continue their life cycle. So in the end, as a consortium, we're trying to come up with innovative approaches to increase potato production and yield all around the world.